Hey, what's up, Grace Middle School? Another reminder, I hope you aren't getting tired of seeing my face a few times a week, actually several times a week. Do you guys realize how much you're seeing me as compared to before? I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing for y'all. I wish I could see you guys more than what I'm seeing you, you know, on the Wednesday nights and Sunday mornings. Listen, I wanted to encourage you through this time. You know, one of the things I've been thinking about as this quarantine or stay-at-home order is extended is like, what, God, what do you want to teach me? Or what can I learn? How can I grow during this time? If you're like me, I'm getting a little bit tired of this stay-at-home thing. I'm fighting times where almost I start to feel depressed and I'm just anxious to get back with people. Kind of, that's my thing. But God's wanted to teach us a lot through this. And so for me, I'm like sitting down frequently to say, okay, God, what's next? What do you want me to learn? He brought this to my mind. In the Old Testament, there were several times where God asked his people, the Israelites or the Jews, he asked his people to separate themselves from the pagans or from those who didn't follow and didn't worship God. We actually see this several times in the Old Testament. And the reason that that was being asked or commanded of the Israelites is because as they mingled or as they their lives were mixed with the pagans, that they started to live like the pagans, like their actions and their thoughts, the way that they worshiped. So they would start worshiping other gods rather than worshiping God. And so he asked them to separate themselves from the pagans and to come back to him. In other words, to kind of alter their lives and alter the patterns of their lives to resemble the people of God. Well, perhaps during this time, God can do the same thing with us. I know he can with me. So I'm going to ask the question of you. Could this time be a time where God has separated you from the things of the world? And that could be relationships you had with people at school or things that you got caught up doing as you hung out with friends or those people who don't follow God, don't worship God, don't love God. Perhaps this is a time where God has separated us from those things. So think about friends that you might hang out with at school or in the neighborhood or at the YMCA or on a sports team. And those friends had a negative influence on you or a negative impact on your relationship with God. Perhaps this is a time where God has separated you from that so you can kind of reset the way that you think about him, kind of reset your actions and the way that you've been living, the way that you've been worshiping God. Think about that, because this is a perfect time to do that, right? Because we don't have a choice. We have been separated from the world. Most of you are staying at home. We can't go anywhere. We can't hang out with friends, even with church, right? We're meeting virtually. So this is certainly a time where we've been forced to separate ourselves from the world. But there's going to be a time when we have to go back into all of that. So my thing is this: allow God to speak to you and teach you. Write down a list of things that you have found during this time that you're separate from. Again, maybe it's conversations that you were caught up in with friends at a school, or just the notice that you've noticed that your attitude has changed, possibly towards your parents or towards your siblings because you're not hanging out with those people at school. The thing is this: the world, those who don't love Jesus, can really have a negative impact on us. And this is a time where God has separated us from that. So explore that a little bit. Ask God what he's wanting to speak to you and what he's wanting to teach you during this time. Don't forget the Zoom call on Wednesday night. I hope that I see more of you. We've had about 30, 31, 32 show up for that. So hopefully we'll see a few more of you join us. That should be a good time. You can continue to send in your journal entries. Every five entries that you send me is a chance to win a $25 Amazon gift card. And then pay attention to the email that comes out on Thursday, because I always include just a little secret in that that also gives you another chance to win. I love you guys. Can't wait till we can get back together again. Enjoy your week. Stay safe, stay healthy, and we'll hopefully see you Wednesday night, if not Sunday.